The long wait is over. AMT's 1964 Convertible Customizing Kit 3-in-1 stock custom racing of the F85 Cutlass Convertible. Check this thing out. They did all the retro boxing goodness on it. They restored the molds. They improved the molds for the glass and the body. They retooled them. They've got all kinds of custom parts in here, custom body, race equipment, and custom engine, or you can build a bone stock 64 Cutlass convertible. Let's start taking a look at the parts in the box. We got two steering wheels, obviously one custom, one stock for us there. Those are all set to go in the box. We got a good amount of plastic in here, but it's not a super complicated model. We've got our engine parts, halves. We got some custom parts, oil pan, belt and pulley system, manifolds, all nice looking, all clean. We got headers and manifolds on there. Nice looking. They took care of it. They made sure this wasn't going to be a flashy model. We got some custom bumpers. We got optional disc brakes there. We got some sort of custom cowl piece here. They restored all the custom pieces, all the original pieces to the kit when it was released. Check out the side pipes on this thing. Even molded open, or at least dimpled at the ends. We got our nice detailed firewall. For being a promo style kit, it's got a lot of nice parts in there. We got our custom dashboard with detail. We've got some seat belts, radiator. We got them license plates, fire extinguisher. Look at this thing, this custom cowl. So it's just a one seater. You bought a car big enough to seat six people. Now you can only put one in it. It's for the solitary folks out there. We got louvers on the hood, hood pins, bulge for the custom engine. On this one, we've got our wheel backs. We've got our snap rings to hold the interior in. We've got our beautiful stock hood with the nice groove down the center, molded up high so we can get our trim on there. And it does say Oldsmobile across the front of the hood. We've got our beautiful stock dashboard. That's a lot to detail in there. That'll be fun. We've got the boot for the convertible top, so you can put that over there. And it has a nice vinyl texture with grooves, as if it is real fabric. We've got our seats here. Nice textured, like a tuck roll type texture on the stock seats. And we've got our custom bucket seats. We've got the entire frame, exhaust, drive shaft, differential, fuel tank, in this promo style suspension. These don't bother me at all. These are easy to paint up, decorate them by hand. You have a more than competent looking model, and who flips them over anyways unless you take them to a show? We've got our interior tub here. We've got decent side panel details. Rear seat is molded in with that same tuck roll style material. We've got our carpet and our center console molded in. Sharp looking. I've got the body here. Now, the reason I left it like that is I want to see how yours is going to come to protect it, because I get production models. I don't get anything special or previews or anything. I get what you're going to get. We'll slide this out of here really carefully. I don't break the frame of that winch. Boy, they wedge that in there. Be careful, people. So that's your cardboard. They just wedge that in there to keep that windshield straight and tight. It is in there tight, so take your time. But that means you will be delivered a body, a retooled body that is in mint condition, sharp details. Look at that lovely lady. Don't cut these off. That's what holds your hood up. Beautiful trim. Trim all the way down the sides. That is quite shallow on the side. So when we have to decorate that, we'll probably have to mask that. I'll show you how to do that. Got the trunk lid, so you can tell it's been redone because it's so crisp, and lots of detail all on there for your building pleasure. We'll put that aside. Let's jump at the other stuff that's in the box. We've got new bumpers, chrome parts. They've made sure to retool the stock parts so that they look awesome. Check that out. Extra crisp and clean. Nice looking rear bumper. grill assembly with the headlights and everything molded in. Easy enough to detail. We've got our custom parts. Sets of wheels. We got two sets of wheels. We got custom blower parts. We got lower trim for the body. Bumper, Oldsmobile inserts. We'll see what all parts of these are custom or which ones we put in a stock configuration. We'll see that in the show off. We'll show the whole tree there. Up next are the clear parts. We got a whole bunch of those. We got stock taillights. We got custom taillights molded in transparent red. Those are nicely done. I like when they're in that transparent red. Less paint time for me. We got that nice windshield, crystal clear. We got that custom cowl. Again, crystal clear, very sharp, nice looking. We got more custom parts here. Check that stuff out. It's got the like a interesting, it doesn't even feel rough, but it's like molded in this cool little hex pattern in there with some headlights. Other side lights or tail lights for the car. What else we got? We got a box of screws because it is a promo style model with some steel axles. We've got a set of four tires, white wall on one side, Firestone Supreme. Can you see that lettering on there and the Firestone logo? Firestone Supremes on the other side. You get four of those. And of course, the new and improved decal sheet. Beautiful stock gauges. Look at that. No paintwork needed. Then we've got all of our custom stuff. That's about the only gauge on there. There is no other logos for the vehicle. So you'll have to decorate those by hand if you build the complete stock one. And that is your full decal sheet for the model if you go race or custom. Still getting excited about that nice dash panel. I don't even have to paint any of that. That saves 45 minutes. That's everything that's in the box. I'm going to get to building mine and I'll be right back. If you're going to build the stock drop top like I am, really you're only going to invest at the most an hour into assembly if you're going to do a basic build like I do. I've got a lot of the parts cut free. I always like to do that so I can get things painted up separately. When I cut them off the trees, then I will just touch up any paint if needed on those small areas with a brush. Check out that nice V8 transmission. Even got the little oil filter. Of course, it has a hole through the block because that's how we get our wire axle through there. It's just reminiscent of the older style kits, but that's what it looks like when it all goes together. And it had no issues gluing together. I didn't need to file or sand anything. It all went together nicely without a problem. Same as the belt and pulley system. That's ready to go. We got our air cleaner. The interwebs tells me the engine is gold and the air cleaner is red. So that's what I'm going to go with. And if that's not right, you should talk to the guys that restore them because they take pictures of the real car. That's our little battery. We got our steering wheel that we saw earlier going with a stock steering wheel. I'm going to leave the hood and the wheel backs on here and I'm going to paint them all up as one. These are little rings that go and push the interior through and then lock it into place. So I'm just going to paint that all as one. The wheel backs, I'm not too concerned about their color at this point. We've got our nice boot and our dashboard, which on this car are going to end up the same color. So we've got those ready to go. The chrome parts need to be sprayed with a matte clear coat for me and then detailed. Same as the bumper and the rear bumper. I want to do some special detailing on that, so we'll get to that. The interior is just as is, going to spray it and work on it. The body, since the underhood is black, I've already attached the firewall and the radiator, and then I will go in and get the body painted and quickly and easily hand paint that firewall, but then I know it's in there with model glue and it's not going to come loose. It's got large locating slots where it should go. And the radiator is just a nice friction fit, so it all goes in lovely. We can get some paint on that bad boy and be ready to go. Now, if you're going to be super, super worried about detail, there are a couple sink marks in the top of the trunk lid that I noticed more carefully there. You can see it kind of reflecting. You may want to fill those with a little putty. It's just from the molding of these large pins and all that. It's not going to be a problem for me. So I will be painting this a lighter color. It won't show up at all. And the chassis, of course, will get paint. That is it. The subassembly only takes a couple minutes because there really is not much to it. It's a nice simple kit of building a nice Oldsmobile convertible for 1964. So I'm going to get all this stuff in its clamps and off to the paint right now.
Thank you. Thank you.
Well, after that marathon session of music and building, here we are. We've got a lot of stuff going on here, and we'll talk about what it is. You can see how that chassis turns out after we weather it and beat it up. Now, the engine and transmission need a little more weathering. I'm gonna be putting some black washers and stuff on those, but that's how it looks right now. I'll be using a little bit of black mixed with windshield washer fluid and stuff to grease up the engine. We'll get that done before we're all done with the model. The interior is ready to be put inside. We got our nice silver trim on the console. We got our shifter glued into place. We've got our steering wheel and dash with that nice huge decal. With the decal solvent, that decal settles right down into all the details. No issues. That's the only decal we have to apply on the kit. We got our interior done, shredded a little bit. The door panels accented with some silver marker. And that is ready to go itself. That's ready to be placed up into the body. We got the front bumper and rear bumper and grill all set and gone. Rusted up with a little bit of that spray over the matte coat, and that looks pretty awesome. As you can see, I made sure to mask off the headlights because glass and the chrome behind it doesn't usually rust on these. It's all the exterior stuff that's exposed to the elements. The wheels look awesome. Those are ready to be put inside. We can do black wall. We can do white wall. We can do a mix and match on the final product. We'll see what we decide to go with. We've got that white top. Might have had a black one with a black interior, but it has a white one now, and I did a very light coat of that over the black primer so that it looks dirty and faded. That will sit on the body like so. Over the back, that's gonna look pretty awesome back there. We got our red air cleaner. We got our battery ready to glue against the radiator mount. So that's all set. We got the chassis there. We got the body. You can see I'm doing a hood of a different color. And I had a happy accident like the master Bob Ross does. I was spraying it. I had sprayed the hood yellow. And then I'm like, no, I want to do a different color hood. Like they had to replace the hood after a while. And I sprayed it with some blue over the top. And they didn't react very nicely with each other, even though they were the same brand. But what happened was we got this crackle peel thing going on. So I took a lighter shade of blue than what I had been using, and I was going to do the same weathering and fading I did on the side and rubbed it in. And when it went into the cracks, that looked to me pretty awesome. Weather checked blue hood from some car, probably down in Arizona, that's been baking in the sun for who knows how many years. And now it's on this Oldsmobile, and I think that looks pretty cool. So I put the silver marker down the center for the trim. I gave it a little dirt and crust on the outside, and now we have an awesome looking mismatched hood for our car. The car itself, you can see, we did the rust details, we did the fading. I got that trim. You can keep messing with that trim until you find a level that you like, where it's been peeled off, where your foot always comes in and out, banged off because of the rust and chipped and fell apart, and now all that chrome trim is peeling off and falling apart. Make sure to weather up your visors a little bit. We got the body ready to go. This trim is rusted, but it's not peeling off anywhere. The passenger side's always treated a little lighter. And then we detailed underneath the hood with some dry brushing of those rust and dirt tones, and our radiator mount and everything. And the little pins that hold the hood up, I made sure to paint those black so they don't stand out as much as if I had left them yellow. For inside the door seams and the trunk, I just used a Gundam pen, which is just a fine black pen. Molotow makes them, everything. So you can detail it to your heart's content and then glued the windshield in with some Mod Podge like I do on all my videos. Some of the products I went through when working on this one, some enamel browns, craft paint blue, craft paint black, chalk craft paint, which gives me a dead flat look, some craft paint silvers, brown oxide, burnt sienna. You can go any colors that look like rust, just grab them off the shelf. Stop asking, what's the exact color that you use? I must know the exact color that you're using on your models. Doesn't matter, guys, just go to the craft store. Oh, brown oxide, yeah, that looks like rust. Oh, raw sienna, it looks like dirt and rust. Just buy it and enjoy yourself. And then the crackle medium, which other artists use for all kinds of painting and stuff, works just well for models. Now, I don't know if a model enamel paint or an airbrushed lacquer or whatever will work with this. I use craft paints and they work with it beautifully. Don't ask me if it works with other brands of paints because I haven't tested it and I don't know. So that is everything. All I've got to do really is push everything together. You can see how easy the interior goes into this. Very promo-esque. Check that out. Right away, it's got character. So I'm going to put everything, just push it all together and stick the wheels and tires on. We'll be back for the final. That's all she wrote for another kit. Lots of you have been waiting for this one, talking about it, complaining in advance without ever seeing it. The 1964 convertible customizing kit. Oldsmobile F85 Cutlass convertible. It needs a longer name. 3-in-1 stock custom and racing kit from AMT, from the folks at Round 2 that sent this over. Thanks a billion, guys, for sending that to me for another build-up. We got a lot more kits coming up, of course, but this one is on the table now. Super easy promo-style kit, but with an engine and transmission to put under the hood. Nice-looking interior, as you can see. If you want to go with a beautiful showroom Mecum auction restoration, you go right ahead. I've heard that they are producing a hard top version of this kit, and when I saw pictures of that, I thought, well, this one, now I can beat this one up and I'll do the other one nice. We can have the best of both worlds. I like crusting up the convertibles because you can see right down inside, and the seats and all that in those would get really beat up too and kind of shredded. So had fun with this, a little bit of a happy accident with that hood. I didn't mean to go that roach with that hood, but we'll say it sat outside in the Arizona sun for many years and the guy needed a new hood, so that's the one he grabbed. Goes together nice, not going to have any problems with parts lining up or things going together. It just literally, like I showed you, pushes together real easy. They include the dash decal. Hopefully for the other series, maybe we can get some Cutlass logos, maybe the one for the hood. We don't know. Hopefully, you know, they watch the videos, they say, oh yeah, we could add some of those in that other decal sheet. But for this one, you get the one for the dash, which makes your life a lot easier. I used a small silver pen to do the logos. You saw how I did that trim. The trim is quite shallow, so I did want to mask that off, or I never would have been able to follow that with just the marker by itself. Otherwise, everything else came out lovely. The panel lines are deep enough that you can get your accent in there so they stand out on a light-colored body. And it's a nice-looking kit, and it looks exactly the part when we're done. Has a gajillion parts left inside there that I'll be recycling. But you can make a really cool custom Oldsmobile as well, like that one-seater. So show me the pics on the hpiguys Workshop Facebook page. I'll be happy to see them. As always, when you build your model, build it the way you want to see it and no one else. That's what I do on every single video, and I have a good time doing it. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see you all at the next review.